Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about supervised learning versus unsupervised learning versus reinforcement learning. These are considered the three pillars of machine learning. So first up is supervised learning. Supervised learning is about learning to predict an output given an input. So say for example, we had machine learning model 1, which we'll just draw with a green box. The particular algorithm doesn't really matter. Supervised learning models require an input. So maybe we had this image of a cat sticking its tongue out apparently, and that gets input to the machine learning model. Supervised learning models also have an output that's specific to this input. Maybe the output was the label of cat because the model was trying to figure out what was present in the image. We'll take the same machine learning model, Model 1, and since its input is images, we could give it this input of a dog. So that gets input into the model, and the corresponding output we'd get, we hope that it is dog, because that's the object that's present in this image. Of course, the model could have also predicted that this image was a cat, but that would be wrong. We hope that the model gets more and more accurate over time, with more and more data that it is given. Okay, another supervised learning example, machine learning model 2. Maybe this machine learning model received not an image of Bill Gates, but his weight, so just the number 61 kilograms. We'd feed that weight into the model as an input. The corresponding output, well, we can try and predict whatever we want. So maybe we were trying to predict his height, which happens to be 1.77 meters. If our model predicted this exactly, it would be perfectly close, and if it predicted something close, like 1.75 meters, then it would be relatively accurate as well. However, if it predicted something very wrong, like 4 meters, that would be a very bad model. Maybe we had the same model, and we'll input Elon Musk's weight. He usually weighs a little bit more. His weight seems to fluctuate depending on how much he works, and since he just acquired Twitter, he's probably gonna gain a little bit of weight. And so we'll input his weight into the model, and since he weighs a little bit more than Bill Gates, a higher weight may correspond to a higher height, and it does for Elon. He is a little bit taller at 1.88 meters. Again, we hope that our model outputs something close to accurate. Very much depends on the quality of the data and the amount of data that our model has seen. Okay, so that was supervised learning. We're learning from inputs to predict outputs. Now, unsupervised learning. Unsupervised learning is mostly about finding patterns in data. So let's look at an example. I'll make a graph, and so here's my x and y axis. If you haven't seen a graph before, don't worry, this will still make sense. And we'll put weight in kilograms on the x-axis, and we'll mark points 10 kilograms, 20, 30, and 40 kilograms respectively. And on the y-axis, we'll mark height in meters with marks 1, 2, and 3 meters. And say we had a full data set, many examples of weird alien creatures, and we measured both their weight in kilograms and their height in meters. So maybe this one weird alien creature was this red point here, and we placed it here because it has a 10 kilogram weight and a 1 meter height. A similar alien is a little bit shorter and a tiny little bit less weight at maybe 0.7 meters and 9.8 kilograms. The exact measurements don't really matter. Now let's plot all of our other alien points. So maybe these are all of our different aliens here. You can look at all of their different heights in meters and weight in kilograms. And that's all the aliens that we have. We collected the weight and height of 25 different aliens. Unsupervised learning is about finding patterns in data, and there's a pretty clear pattern here. There's a group over here, there's a group over here, a group in the top left here, and a group in the top right here. There's more analysis you could do towards this, but this is already an example of unsupervised learning. In fact, it's something called clustering, which just means grouping like this. Okay, that was unsupervised learning. Now onto reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is about teaching an agent how to interact with its environment in order to meet its objective or goal. An agent doesn't have to be a secret agent like James Bond. It can simply be a goat. Maybe this goat is learning how to run. So at first, it fails to run, and it's going to try something new. It'll interact with its environment differently, it'll run in a slightly different way, and maybe it'll now run a little better. And it tries something new, learns a little more, keeps trying, and it gets better and better all the time, and eventually, ta-da! This goat eventually learned to solve its goal of running. Okay, that was reinforcement learning. So in summary, the three pillars of machine learning are supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. Supervised learning uses inputs to predict outputs. Maybe it learns to predict that an image is representing a cat versus a dog. Or maybe it learns the relationship between height and weight. Unsupervised learning tries to find patterns in data. So maybe there's particular groups in data, and there's other examples as well. Reinforcement learning teaches an agent how to behave in its environment in order to meet a goal. Through trial and error, it will get better and better. That's the end of the video. Drop a thumbs up if it was helpful, and subscribe for more.